animal can be a very rewarding experience. So here to share more about hospice fostering and to remind us about today's adoptable pets is our pet rescue expert, Larissa, and Paw Works Rescue founder, Chad Atkins. Welcome, you all.
Welcome, guys.
Thank you.
Thanks, Chad, for being here.
Thanks. So, Larissa, I know you recently embarked on a new experience for even you, which I thought was impossible when
right.
it came to animals.
So did I.
Yeah, you know, right before Christmas, Chad, who I adore, who runs Paw Works here in LA, he posted about a dog named Sawyer, who they had picked up from the shelter in horrific condition, an older guy who really needed a home for the holidays. And I jumped in and I said, I can't keep him, but I can keep him for a couple days until you find a long-term foster. I didn't realize, and I don't know that any of us really realized that Sawyer was really what's called a hospice foster. Mm. And that's a very different situation, and it was very eye-opening, I would say.
So, Chad, you rescued Sawyer, and you saved his life. But then it was time to find a hospice foster. What does that entail? What goes into that?
So we call it actually a Fospice.
Oh.
So it's a foster hospice. And what it means is we're looking for somebody who is willing to go the long distance, the end of the life, and give them the comfort, the dignity, and the safety that they deserve.
So
I don't even know how you would find that.
I know, it's incredible because, and we'll get to this also, it seems so sad, but it's such a beautiful thing for sure.
Gosh.
Now, I gotta ask you, Larissa, because obviously there's few things in this world, the world of rescues, that you haven't learned about. So what did you learn from this specific experience?
It's funny. I think that's why I wanted to do a segment and talk about this, because I feel like I've seen it all. I've
right.
seen the good, the bad, the ugly. This was eye-opening even to me. That's the biggest, you know, phrase I can use. And I really learned, you know, hospice fostering, Fospice, is very rewarding. And it's all about, as you said, you know, giving the animal the best comfort you can,
right.
letting them sleep in the grass if they want, get that sun on their skin, give them yummy, yummy treats, whether that's chicken or maybe a little piece of cheese or whatnot. And I learned very quickly after having Sawyer for a couple days that I have to learn my boundaries. And I say this to other people looking to foster, whether it's puppies, adults, you know, end of life. I thought I could do it all. And I realized there are certain, depending on your schedule, depending on the animals you have, you really have to know your limits. And Sawyer needed more medical care than I could give. And so Chad was wonderful enough. We got Sawyer to another family who are vets. So they were able to help Sawyer after I was. I also learned it's not about you. So many people say, I can't foster. I couldn't give the dog up. It's too sad. I'd be heartbroken. And in the nicest possible way, it's not about you. You're doing such a selfless thing for these dogs. And seeing Sawyer have that love and that life, even just for a couple days at my house, just reinforced the fact that you're there to help them. And yes, there are some sad moments, but it's about them.
That's a great lesson in general, in life in general, specifically with this, obviously, for sure. And Chad, we've talked a little bit. I mean, it seems like it would be sort of sad for people, obviously, but remember, not about you. Why is this such a beautiful experience for people?
You know, because you give them the dignity and the humanity. I mean, that's why we're here as rescuers, is actually to change the world and to make a difference. And when you are able to make a difference for that one animal, it really is a beautiful thing. It also inspires us to go on and save the next animal, because there are so many elderly animals in the shelter that need this type of help.
And you know, having said that, like what I was saying, I can't imagine how difficult it would be for you all to find a hospice foster or Fospice, because it's like Larissa said, it's difficult on the human.
It's extremely difficult. I mean, as Larissa learned,
I called him at 1 a.m.
She did, and I answered my phone because that's what I do. And what she learned was there are limits to what we're able to do. You know, I actually can't take in fosters because I have an older dog that doesn't get well along with other dogs, so I had to learn my limits as a rescuer. Mm. So we all learn our limits, and it's a beautiful thing when you're able to figure out what your skill and your gift is.
And to know that you might have one day, you might have one week, that's
it. You might have 1 hour.
And you know I have to say, you know, Sawyer on New Year's passed away by the fire, curled up, having had a wonderful few days of yummy treats and hugs. And to know that we helped you primarily to give that gift to him, when who knows what his life was like before, is just, it's a really, really positive, beneficial experience.
Guys are like angels. Thank you so much for what you do for these little animals. You give them a voice because they don't have one. So thank you for that.
Thank you.
So Larissa, Give us the voice of the two adoptable animals yes. that are looking for the forever home.
Yes, yes, and they are up for fostering, for adopting as well. This is Lilo, who's sitting here wanting more cheese. She is a 2-year-old terrier dachshund. I said she should be called Ginger because this coloring of fur is just beautiful. She has exuberant energy. She loves to run around. She only has 3 legs because one had to be amputated because she was hit by a car. But if you look at this video, she does not realize it. And she will never realize it. So she is ready for a wonderful home. She gets along with cats, dogs, and kids and humans of all ages. And of course, you can go to pawworks.org. And then we have a little kitty who's also up for adoption today. I'm gonna give you a little piece of cheese. Yeah. And the kitty is named Sparrow, and it's a female, 2 years old. Sparrow is basically a dog hiding in a cat's body because she loves to explore. She jumps, she talks, she sits on your shoulders like a parrot. And she is just a wonderful outgoing kitty cat. So if you're looking for a very interactive cat, this is your gal. And she is also at pawworks.org in LA.
You know what? 2 gorgeous animals. Yeah. And thank you again, both of you, for all that you are doing out there, for sure. Everybody, as always, check out hallmarkchannel.com and savebythel.com to see our daily animals. And you can also go to pawworks.org for more of their available pets as well.